Hello, this is Lazarus at telecomTech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining OSPF and how it propagates default routes. As a routing protocol, OSPF advertises those routes that have been configured using the network command or that have been redistributed locally into the OSPF domain. But what about default routes? How does OSPF handle those? In this video, we'll go over how OSPF deals with default routes and how those are to be configured within Cisco devices. By default, OSPF does not advertise default routes of any type. You must explicitly configure something to make OSPF share those routes, and there are a couple of ways to do that. You can do it by either using the default information originate feature or by using redistribution, and we'll briefly look at both. Just a clarification here, default routes are also advertised in OSPF by the ABR in stub areas. But that's a special case, and we've already looked at how those work and why they exist, so we won't be looking at those here. Now here's the topology that we'll be using in order to apply the default information originate feature. Now this feature is used to force OSPF to advertise any existing default route in the local routing table. So if R1 here has a default route to the 10.1.1.1 next hop, then we can use this feature to make R1 advertise that route to other OSPF neighbors, such as R2. Now R1 has learned about this default route in some way, either from another routing protocol or a statically configured route. But no matter how it was learned, that default route exists in the routing table. Now let's take a look at the current routing table of R1. As you can see, we have a default route with the next hop of 10.1.1.1. We can see that this is a result of a static route that has been configured, and we can see that from this entry here. This asterisk shows us that it is a candidate default route. As the only candidate, it becomes the gateway of last resort. Now that's just the term used in the routing table in order to refer to the default route. We can also see the directly connected network here on interface gigabit Ethernet 00. There's another directly connected network on gigabit Ethernet 01 as well, but it's not shown in this output. Now we've already configured OSPF in both of these routers such that this network is participating in OSPF. That makes both routers actively search for OSPF neighbors across this link. We assume that they found each other and that they are OSPF neighbors. At this point, no networks are being advertised because no networks have been added using the network command other than this directly connected network. That's why we don't see any other OSPF routes in the routing table of R1. Now let's advertise this default route using the default information originate feature. We go into R1 and into the OSPF configuration mode and issue this command here. That's it. It's just one command. That takes any default route that exists in the local routing table and advertises it using OSPF. Now let's see what we see in R2. You can see that we have a gateway of last resort with the next hop IP of R1. Further down, we can see how this was learned via OSPF. This asterisk again shows that this is a candidate default route. We also see that it is an external type 2 route. And this is interesting here because that means that R1 advertised it using a type 5 LSA. And guess what? That makes R1 an ASBR. Because it is introducing a network from outside of the OSPF domain. So the default information originate feature automatically makes the advertising router an ASBR because it is injecting a route from outside of the OSPF domain. Now there are a couple of things that you have to keep in mind with this feature. If we remove the default route from the routing table by removing the configured static route, then even with the default information originate command configured, OSPF does not advertise a default route. Since there's no default route in the routing table, there's no default route to advertise. So if you look at R2, you'll see that the default route has been removed. However, there is a way to force OSPF to advertise R1 as the next hop for the default route even if R1 doesn't have a default root within its routing table. You can do this using the following modified command on R1. By using the always keyword at the end, this OSPF router will advertise itself as the default gateway, even if it itself doesn't have a default root in its routing table. Now, this is not as common a configuration, but it can be useful when specific routing policies are in place or in order to keep the network stable in the event that the WAN link flaps occasionally. Now, at this point, let me say that the default information originate feature is the primary way in which we advertise default routes in OSPF. However, you can also do it by using redistribution. Now, for redistribution to work, we must have learned of a default route on R1 from some other source. Again, let's assume that we have a static default route configured in R1 as before. We've removed the default information originate command from R1 completely. Now, let's advertise this default route using redistribution this time. We do this using the redistribute static command. Now, in this case, since we only have one static root on R1, only the default root is redistributed into OSPF. If we had other static routes as well, then they too would be redistributed. So that's an issue when it comes to using redistribution for the default route. There is a workaround for this, but I'll mention it shortly. Redistribution could very well take place from other sources, including EIGRP or BGP. It doesn't really matter what the source of the information is. It just requires that the default route advertised by that other source is installed in the routing table, and that is done using redistribution. Now, the result on R2 is the following. You can see that it looks exactly the same as the default information originate feature, and in essence, from the point of view of R2, there's absolutely no difference. Redistribution, as we saw in previous videos, makes R1 an ASBR, and R2 receives an external type 2 route for the default route. Now, redistribution, although it works as a method of injecting a default route, is not as clean as default information originate. Redistribution does not act only upon the default route, but on all routes that have been learned from that particular source. So if you use it and you want to redistribute only the default route, you will have to filter the redistribution process using something like a route map. I won't get into that now, but I wanted to clarify that. So that's it for how OSPF can be used to advertise a default route. Well, I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, I would ask that you consider using the YouTube Super Thanks feature to say thank you and support my effort to simply explain telecom and networking. As I'm always striving to improve my videos, the funds will be used to support better equipment, better quality video editing services, and just to produce more useful training content. And as always, check out my website where you'll find detailed courses with labs, quizzes, and exams to test your knowledge and prepare you for certifications, as well as for the real-world networking and telecom industry. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel to get updates to newly published videos. I'm Lazarus at telecomTech. I hope this has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.